I thought something was going.
Hollywood, the Raleigh Cigarette Program, starring Red Skelton, Dave Rose and his orchestra, our singing star, Anita Ellis, Verna Felton, Lorene Tuttle, Pat McGee, and yours truly, Rod O'Connor. From Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, we present the star of the Raleigh Cigarette Program, Red Skelton.
Thank you very much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you, Rod?
Well, Red, what are you so sad about?
Haven't you heard? Henry Morgan's losing his sponsor.
Well, why should you be sad about that? He's so funny, he'll probably get another sponsor right away.
That's why I'm worried. Might be my sponsor.
Why, Red, you know Mr. Raleigh thinks of you as a brother.
Yeah, every week after the program, he says, oh, brother.
But you're doing fine. Why, last week you were asked to entertain the Marine Corps at their 172nd anniversary.
Mm-hmm.
Do they like the act you put on?
Well, yeah, and in the middle of... I like to punch the guy in the nose that told me that would get a laugh. In the middle of my act, I heard one sergeant say, look, we took Saipan, we took Guadalcanal, but brother, we don't have to take this.
Well, did anybody ask for your autograph?
One guy, but I turned him down.
Why, was he the recruiting officer?
He was the recruit. Hey, wait, that's mine. That says Red, don't it? How do you like that? He can't think of an ad lib, so he reads my joke. Hey, what's the news? What's the news of the day? Walter Kiernan wasn't on today. I was a little disappointed. I don't know what's going on.
He's on a vacation. He's got a sub.
Oh, no. Defensive sub, huh?
Yeah. Well, what's new, you asked, Red? They're talking about dividing Los Angeles into five boroughs with separate local governments.
Five boroughs, mm-hmm. Huh? Well, there's a jackass out in my neighborhood. That'll make six, you know. They want Milton they can throw him into.
Well, say, did you notice where the Davis Car Company of Van Nuys successfully produced the first three-wheel automobile?
Well, that's a step in the right direction, but it's not far enough, you know.
How do you figure that?
Well, the odds against the pedestrians are still 3-2. Hey, have you heard about my new invention? I've got a new invention. It's called the California Pedestrian Fountain Pen.
Really?
Yeah, it writes under automobiles. What else is in the paper, Rod?
Well, Red, did you know that last week California had the coldest November day in 36 years?
Yeah, I know. I woke up and my canary was wearing the cat around the house.
Now, listen.
Clem! Ron O'Connor's on.
Just a minute, Mrs. Cadiddle Hopper. I'm about to tell our listeners about the revolutionary moisturizing process that makes the new Raleigh 903 such a wonderfully rich, full-flavored, yet milder smoking cigarette.
Well, now, Mr. O'Connor, you go right ahead.
Okay. Listen to this jet of fresh, pure moisture.
Clem!
It's moisturized.
Mr. O'Connor, are you calling my boy Clem a drip?
Well, of course not, Mrs. Cadiddle Hopper. I'm only telling folks that the new, all-new Raleigh 903s are moisturized to cut down those throat-irritating tars, present in even the finest tobaccos. But no other leading cigarette gives you less throat irritants.
Why?
Because they're moisturized.
You said that.
Of course I did. That's what a jury of 14 distinguished doctors says about the new Raleigh 903. No other leading cigarette gives you less throat irritants.
Mr. O'Connor, a jury of distinguished doctors came to see Clem when he was a young'un.
Really? What did they say?
Don't you believe it.
And now here's our beautiful Anita Ellis, who will sing her latest Mercury recording, Gold Earrings.
There
story that's known to very few. But if you wear these golden earrings, love will come to you.
Book of satire. He's got termites in the drumsticks now. Chapter.
You feel better, Noisy?
Huh? Chapter 10 is entitled The Honky-Tonk Photographer.
Nice, Willie, walking along the boardwalk. You like it?
No, I don't. People bumping into me all the time, they get me perturbed, they do.
Now, Willie, I'm not going to get mad at you tonight. This is our wedding anniversary, yeah? And this might help us recapture our love. Oh, look, a fun house. Let's stop and look in these trick mirrors.
No, they always make you look like something you're not and glad you ain't.
Look at the way I look in this mirror. My head looks square and my feet look like they're growing out of my ears.
I got news for you. That is not a trick mirror.
Oh, look, Willie, a photo gallery.
Yeah.
They only charge a dollar.
Yeah, Glamour Photograph Studio. Our prices are reasonable. You've let others take you, now give us a chance.
Sounds logical, huh?
I wonder if I'm still as photogenic as I used to be.
You were photogenic? Don't make me laugh. I should have gone to the wedding. You know, you're so ugly you have to sleep on your face all night to keep from scaring the covers off.
Stop and Zigfield. If you think I'm so ugly, why did you marry me?
Who said you were ugly?
You did.
I said you were ugly?
Many times.
Well, you ought to be convinced then.
Willie Lumplum, that wasn't nice. Yeah. I'm not so bad looking. After all, beauty is only skin deep.
Yeah, but homely is clear to the bone.
Let's go in and get our picture taken. It only costs a dollar.
I don't have a dollar.
Well, I've got a $10 bill in my stocking. I'll get it. Well, Willie, you haven't whistled at me like that since we were married.
I wasn't whistling at you, kiddo. I haven't seen a $10 bill since we got married either.
Oh, now stop scolding. Do you want to have pictures made or not?
Well, truthfully, I look a mess today, you know. The circles under my eyes are so big, my nose looks like it's riding a bicycle. Well, now let's read what's written here. The circles under my eyes are so low, it makes me look like I'm wearing a mustache. The bicycle's got it. Come Come on, double ugly. Come on, come on.
Oh, Willie, you can't mean that. I can't be too bad. Why, before we were married, you used to spend at least 20 minutes kissing me goodnight.
Well, I had to pass the time until the bus come tonight. Come on, we'll go in. If it'll make you happy, we'll get our pictures taken.
Well, well, welcome to Glamour Studios. Do you want your pictures taken?
You don't do embalming here, do you? If you do, you can take that circle joke that died and bury it. Certainly we want our pictures taken.
Well, do you want something in the comedy vein, or did you bring some other clothes with you? Hey, Mr. Clark.
Yes, Mr. White? Oh, is it Halloween already?
No, no. No, these two want their pictures taken. Before you focus the camera, you better put safety glass lens in to keep it from shattering.
Put a mic out there. Somebody's reading the lines with you.
I said before you focus the camera, you better put safety glass lens in to keep it from shattering.
Roger, right over here, folks.
Now, what background would you like to be photographed at? The Honeymoon Express? The bar room?
That sounds good.
Or maybe the horse and shay.
The bar sounds good. Bar sounds good.
Don't you have something to fit my personality?
You want something to fit your... You don't want to pose peeking out of a gopher hole, do you?
Why don't you play the game DDT?
DDT, what's that?
Drop dead twice.
All right, friends, now sit right over there. That's okay. It. Now, let's see how you look through the camera.
Okay. Hey, let me take a look, too. I've always wanted to look through one of these things.
Okay.
Know.
Look through this glass right here.
Okay. Just a minute. What are you trying to pull? All I see is my wife in there. I'm not even in the picture. Wait, a wise guy is coming?
Naturally, you're not in the picture. How could you be in the picture when you're standing behind the camera here?
Let's not change the subject, Bob.
Look, you want a profile picture?
Yes. Get my legs in.
Why?
Why?
Yeah.
You used to tell me that my legs reminded you of Grable.
I said Gable. Gable. Gable's legs are back and you got them, I said.
All right, now, sit down next to her and put your arms around her.
Okay.
Now I shall open the shutter.
Hey, what are you doing with that rubber ball with a hose on it? Look, Rembrandt. If you squirt water in my face, brother, you're gonna get it.
Now, look, take it easy,
you
Mac.
You take it easy, Mac. I don't want to get my suit wet, see? I don't like practical jokes, see? This is one of those post-war suits. I wore the other one I got the other day in the rain, and the pants shrunk so bad I had to trim my shorts.
Hey. Could you two get
Wait
a little...
here, we'll make up something.
Could you two get a little closer together? A little closer? Closer? That's good!
Shall I turn my head toward her? I'm on the other side of her now.
Yeah, look at me. And take your big feet off my lap.
My feet ain't big.
No, you're the only fellow I know who's taller lying down than standing up.
Look, lovey-dovey, your tootsies ain't so tiny either. I stepped on your toes at the dance last night, and you didn't feel the pain till we were driving home. Speaks of big, you have to use ironing boards for inner soles. Back out of the room to admire the rug. Feet jokes don't go. I'm sorry I said.
If you please, Ed. Can you turn your shoulder a little to me, madame?
She ain't got no shoulders. Her neck sticks out of her hips. I still don't get it.
When you get home.
Oh, that's a good one, isn't it?
And look in the camera here.
Yeah.
All right, careful, smile.
Yeah.
Now watch the boy D.
Yeah.
Hold it! Oh... You broke my camera. You broke my camera.
Oh, shut up.
Listen. That sound of fresh, pure moisture stands for the new, all-new Raleigh 903 cigarette. It's moisturized to cut down throat irritants. Yes, it's moisturized to cut down those throat-irritating tars present in even the finest tobaccos. A jury of distinguished doctors says this about the new Raleigh 903. No other leading cigarette gives you less throat irritants.
Yes, Raleigh 903 is moisturized by the revolutionary new 903 process to cut down throat irritants. That's why Raleigh 903 brings you a rich, full-flavored, yet milder smoking cigarette.
Smokers, follow the lead of Ella Raines, featured in Nunley Johnson's Universal International picture, The Senator Was Indiscreet. Miss Raines says, quote, I have changed to the new Raleigh 903. Because it's moisturized, it tastes better and it's milder to smoke. Unquote. So do as Ella Raines does. Smoke Raleigh 903. Moisturized to cut down throat irritants. Remember, it's moisturized to cut down throat irritants.
Now Dave Rose and his Raleigh Cigarette Orchestra play Orpheus on Vacation, or Vaudeville is Dead. Well, that was Orpheum, wasn't it? Chapter 2 of The Little Boy and His Dog. Now, come on, puppy dog. Come on. I'm going to feed you. It's almost time for supper, see? Now, I feed you now, and then you won't eat so much when them all feed you, and then you'll think you're a big eater, and you can stay, see? Now, come on. You sit down by here, and I open up the icebox. Now, stay there. Right, 25. Left, 29. Right, 10. Change the combination again.
Now I've caught you raiding the icebox between meals.
Well, who, me? What make you think I would do the trick like that?
Well, if you weren't, what is the ice bar door doing open?
The ice bar door? You want to try it again? You want to try it again, Yarmouth?
Yes, I do.
See, my grandpa drinks so much that we got an ice bar instead of a box.
Junior, what is the ice box door doing open?
I don't know. I got the slightest idea. Maybe the widow man that works in the light in there has been calling the phone.
Junior, there's no man in the ice box.
There ain't?
No.
There was this morning. Grandpa came home with the milk truck again. And he said he was to buy the milk. And to prove it, he put himself in the ice box with the other three quarts.
Now, you know that's not the truth.
Oh, no? Then this afternoon, why did you put him out on the front porch with the other empties? Boy, did he get homogenized last night, boy. he said he was half cream, he was. Now, every time he mentions food, he barks.
Oh, goodness, he's the homeliest dog I ever saw. Get him out of here.
No, he's a valuable dog, he is. He's a gopher hound. Come on, make friends with me, Nemo. Come on, doggy, come on.
What's he growling at me for? I'm not a gopher.
Well, I don't know. You can't fool a dog. If he growls at you, you must be a gopher. A gopher.
Get him out of here. Why, he's the silliest looking dog I've ever seen.
Listen to him sing. Listen to him sing.
Just listen to that. He sounds like a tired coyote.
Please, not so loud. I know he sounds like a tired coyote, and you know he sounds like a tired coyote, but he thinks he's a tired Hildegard.
Well, you can't keep him. Where would he sleep at night?
On me bed.
Junior, that's not healthy.
I won't breathe in his face. Why, his mouth is big and dark. I wonder if there's a light goes on inside when you close it.
Well, why don't you stick your head in and see?
Oh, no! I ain't putting me little thinker between his choppers, boy.
Well, I'm glad to hear you realize the danger of a strange dog.
Danger?
Yes. He might bite your head and break his teeth.
Yes. Oh, you sure does love me, don't you, huh?
Now, that's enough of your foolishness. Put him out and let him find his way home.
Oh, please, Nemo. Please let me keep the widow doggy, would you? I don't have anyone to play with. And the widow dog would be so much company for widow kitties like me. More people should get widow dogs for the widow kitties. And that way they take care of him and they will learn responsibility, see? If you let him run the street, somebody will get him for vivisection or something, you know? And I could keep him here and you can explain to me, Mommy, how much I love the puppy dog. And I'll be good to him, Nemo. Please let me keep the dog. Would you please let me keep the dog?
Oh, you know I'm a sucker for that Betty Davis act.
Yeah.
Get up. Yeah. Get up off your knees before the dog bites your ear. Raw meat makes puppies sick.
Yeah. Hey, look at him. He's scratching. What's wrong with him?
He's got a bite. He's got fleas.
He has?
Yes.
I want some, too.
You don't want fleas.
Yes, I does. I would. Then you could buy some flea soap for me. I want a million fleas just crawling all over me and just bite me until you had to soak me in coal, kerosene, you know. Then you could light a match and burn them all up at once. Me be the flaming torch running around with little barbecued fleas hopping up on me. Oh, no.
What's wrong?
I scared me, John.
Poor baby.
Yeah, poor baby.
Bless his little heart.
Yeah, bless his little heart.
Stop crying.
Yeah, stop crying. Yeah, can I keep the dog?
Oh, I guess he'll keep your mind off of so many things to do.
Yeah, trusting old soul, ain't you?
Go outside and play.
Okay, come on, puppy, come on. Now, let's see. What can we do? It's so early in the morning. Let's shake the tree and see if the birds are asleep. We'll wake them up. When Junior wakes up, everybody wakes up. Oh, look, there's somebody calling through Mr. Fowler's window over there. Well, I'll show Nemo what a good watchdog you is. Stick him, Nicky. Stick him. Go get him. Go get him. Hurry.
Junior, it's me, Mr. Fowler. I got locked out of my house, and I've got to go through a window.
Stick him. Get him.
For goodness sakes, Junior, call that dog off. Can't you see it's me, Mr. Fowler?
I'm sorry. I don't have me bifocals on. Stick him, boy. Stick him.
Your dog's got me by the leg of my pants. Call him off, and I'll give you a big piece of pie.
Apple pie?
Yes, it's apple pie.
With cream on top of it?
Yes.
And cheese on top of that?
Yes.
Wouldn't eat the stuff.
Junior, Junior, the dog is pulling on my new pants. I've never worn them before.
Yeah, you're never going to wear them again, either.
Junior, what are you doing? Good heavens, get that dog off Mr. Fowler.
But Namor, they is good friends. Look how attached they are to each other.
Come here, Nicky. Junior, why did you let your dog attack Mr. Fowler? He wouldn't have done it if you hadn't ordered him to.
Well, I thought Mr. Fowler was a burglar. He was breaking in his house. I thought he was a burglar.
A what?
Well, help me out. I can't say it.
Burglar, darling.
That's what I said, yes, a burglar. Yeah, I wanted to prove that Nicky was a good watchdog, you know.
A watchdog, eh?
Yeah.
Well, he can watch you get a spanking.
No.
Now, you come here, Junior. No. Over my knee.
You lay a hand on me and you is in trouble.
In trouble?
I will tell on you.